Dorothy. Oh, boy. I wonder who is listening to us out there.
Oh, Ken. Relax. I've been doing this for 83 years. Nothing surprises me until now. Do you know who we have on the show today? The audience is going to love it. This is going to be a great show.
And now, from the golden age of entertainment, Dorothy Dale Kloss, nightclub star of the 1940s, star of the Palm Springs Follies, featured in the Guinness Book of Records 2009 as the oldest living working showgirl in the world and one of a kind at 93. And Ken Prescott, winner of two Los Angeles Dramalogue Awards and star of 42nd Street on Broadway. Together, they are two for the show.
Show. In all kinds of weather, we're two for the show. We're two for the show. We sing together, win, place, or show. We'll sing some songs, in fact, quite a few. We'll do some dance steps, one or two, and have some laughs for all of you. We hope you enjoy them. In fact, you just adore them. We're two for the show.
Hi, everyone. I'm Ken Prescott.
And I'm Dorothy Dale Kloss.
And we are
two for the show.
Okay, so all the decorations from the holidays are down. Well, almost. Boy, I hate to see them go, huh?
Well, yes, we're almost back to normal.
Yeah, well, we'll never be normal completely.
Speak for yourself.
So this week we are tapping into the new year. How do you like that segue?
Well, it's not bad.
Thank you. And we have our ever faithful, ever amazing producer with us, Eric Koppelman. Are you there, Eric?
I am here.
Oh, God. It sounds like God from above.
Ken,
I knew it.
This is your conscience.
You're my conscience. I'm in deep doo-doo. Let me just say that. You know, so we're going to be hearing from Eric, as you just heard, from time to not too often, I hope. I'm just kidding. So say something, Eric.
Something, Eric. There you go.
Eric, how's the weather back there?
You know what? I got to tell you, Dorothy, it's been really, really, really cold. We had a major snowstorm the other day, but today you could walk outside and it's like 60 degrees. So
really?
It's nice. It's a beautiful day today. The snow is melting. It's great.
It's that global warming. I knew it.
Yep. Thanks, Ken. You just drew a
snowballs.
That's a positive thought. You know.
Listen, before we go any further, we want to thank our sponsors, Coffee, that's KOFFI of Palm Springs, Trios of Palm Springs, and George's Alibi and Azul Patio of Palm Springs. You see a theme here? Well, we'll hear more about them in just a few.
Well, we are so thrilled to have on our show today that world-renowned composer Henry Krieger.
Yeah, he wrote Dreamgirls, which has just been revived in London, Sideshow, an amazing musical.
I remember those Sideshows.
Well, actually, this is a little different, but along the same lines. And The Tap Dance Kid, in which I had the pleasure of appearing on Broadway. He is just wonderful.
Well, speaking of tap dancing, not only do Ken and I tap dance from the good old days, but we love all those wonderful movies, you know, from Broadway, the Broadway shows that featured tap dancing.
Yeah, you know, Dorothy and I got our love of tap dancing from all those, well, I won't want to call them old movies, I will call them good movies. And there were wonderful tap dancers like Fred Astaire, Gene Kelly, and Donald O'Connor. Who are some of your favorites, Dorothy?
Let me see. You know, you have to stop talking about old to begin with. Anyhow, old Eleanor Powell, Ann Miller, and of course I love Vera Ellen. I just thought she was terrific. And I did have a chance to meet Peter Ford, you know, Eleanor Powell's son. That was a thrill for me, and he was really terrific.
Yeah.
Such a nice man.
Yeah, he was.
And he was so proud of his mother, you
yes,
know.
He was. Yeah. He was such a nice boy. And you know, you guys out there, Dorothy's act was very much like Eleanor Powell when she was young, tap and acrobatics.
Well, those were the good old days when I could actually bend my back that far. But you know, Eleanor bent way back almost to the floor.
Oh, God, don't do that here. You might do yourself a mischief. And here's the surprise we promised you from last week. We are going to tap dance on the show today.
We are.
Good line reading. Like we didn't rehearse in the studio.
Now, wait a minute, Ken. They can't see us, but they can hear us.
Yes, they can. You know, Fred Astaire and Eleanor Powell did a great number in Broadway Melody of 1940. So here are Dot and I doing their opening step. Let's begin the beginning, Eric. Well, that was
well,
us.
That wasn't too bad.
No,
was
go
it?
Ahead.
We ended together.
We did.
There's a basic tap step. There's a basic step in tap dancing that all you dancers out there know, and it's the time step. Well, in the middle of the routine, Fred and Eleanor did a tap, a time step challenge. So here we are just doing that. So all you dancers out there, stand up in your living room and join us.
Here we go. Oh, whew. Boy, I worked up quite a sweat, didn't you?
Not a bit.
Well, while I cool off, let's have a word from our sponsors.
Okay, Dorothy. So, I think we need to head to George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant.
Well, what day of the week is it?
Why, it's Wednesday, of course.
Right, right. Just wanted to make sure we can make that two-for-one happy hour, you know, from 4 to 7.
Oh, right. Monday through Friday. Boy, that's a really great deal. Two-for-one drinks from 4 to 7. And they have great appetizers to go along with those wonderful cocktails. Wait a minute. Are you wearing another hat?
I sure am. And it lights up, see?
Oh, you're all lit up like a Christmas tree.
Oh, well, that's over.
Well, yeah, it is. But what's not over are the wonderful shows at George's Alibi and Azul Patio. That's just a reminder that they are going to have some saucy, sassy, and sensational shows all through the year.
Yes, and you can make an evening of it with cocktails, a delicious dinner, and of course that fantastic show.
Yes, and they have the friendliest waitstaff.
We better go. Go to the phone and make a reservation right now.
Yeah, and all of you, you go to the phone and make your reservations too for a great evening. Or you can do it online at www.alibiazul, that's alibiazul.com.
And don't forget, that's George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant. And remember,
you never have to have an alibi to have a great time. Say, Dorothy, you know, I could really use a cup of coffee, couldn't you?
I sure could. And I bet I know where you want to go, Ken.
Well, is there any other place? Certainly not in Palm Springs. It's coffee. That's coffee with a K. K-O-F-F-I. They really have the best coffee. And you know, the owner has great sticky buns. Well, what I mean is, they have great pastries, incredible muffins, cookies, and even great sandwiches. And the atmosphere is really relaxing. They also have a great patio to watch the world go by.
And you know, you can order their coffee online. So stay tuned and find out how to do that little thing.
Yeah, right after I get that cup of coffee. At coffee, that's K-O-F-F-I. Right here in Palm Springs. Hey, Dorothy, I think it's cocktail time.
Oh, Ken, it's the middle of the afternoon.
Well, it's 5 o'clock somewhere in the world. And what better place to go than Trios of Palm Springs?
Oh, well, wait, I'll get my hat.
Get your hat? What is this, a Joan Crawford movie? Oh, for heaven's sakes. You know, I knew you'd be there. And they have happy hour all day long. And the drinks are just $3.
Well, we've been happy there many times.
We certainly have. And the drinks and the atmosphere are just great.
Also, their bar snacks, like the mac and cheese, are really wonderful. One of my favorites, you know.
Yeah, well, one of my favorites are the sliders. Well, and the spinach dip, Well, oh, they're all my favorites. And it's located in the Uptown Design District of Palm Springs.
So what are we waiting for? I've got my hat.
Oh, again with the hat. Put the hat on. Well, everybody, we hope to see you there soon.
Will I ever get it right? Scared to death. Deep breath. Nervous, nervous. Every night.
Then Jenny makes her entrance with a flare. She counts the house to see who's there.
Then comes Tipsy, but have no fear, 'cause that'll be Daddy bringing up the rear.
Moving to the music, nice and slow, sort of. Easy come, kinda easy go. With a one, two, three for the show. We got a knack for holding back, because we know we got a class act. It's a well-known fact. You can tell by the swell clientele we attract.
Dixie and me,
and Daddy makes three.
We got a top-notch, high-tone, first-class.
Some got the rhythm there, some have not, but we can do the Susie Q, the turkey trot.
Dipsy's fine,
Jenny's fine, and Daddy's red hot. But pull them all together, and what have you got?
Dipsy and me,
and Daddy makes three. We got a top-notch, high-tone, first-class act.
Live from Palm Springs, California, here's Ken and Dorothy.
Wow, that song was a class act from the Tap Dance Kid, and it was a class act indeed. And speaking of class acts, and now, ladies and gentlemen, drum roll, it's our pleasure to have with us today that incredibly talented composer, not to mention nice guy, Mr. Henry Krieger. Yay!
Hi, Henry.
Hey, Ken, how are you doing?
Oh, we're just great. Henry, gosh, it's such a pleasure, and we're so thrilled to have you on the show, aren't we, Dorothy?
Yes, we are. And right off, Henry, what inspired you to compose, you know, a show with tap dancing and then the grandfather being in vaudeville and the follow-through to the next generation? I just think it was terrific. What a great idea and what a show. Henry?
Oh, thank you. It's the book, Nobody's Family is Going to Change. It was really so inspiring, first to our producers, and then they asked us to come along. Louise Fitzhugh wrote it, and we fell in love with it. It's a good story.
It is a great
marker of Harriet the Spy.
Yes, and Charlie Blackwell was involved too, wasn't he?
Yes.
He was a great guy. Henry, I know every artist, and you such an artist, every artist has, different takes on things. How do the words come first? Do the melodies come first?
Usually the words come first. And then sometimes a couple of words come, and then the music comes in a rush, and then the words come. Usually, for me, I like the words first. But,
sometimes
it's a little different.
Yeah. Do you guys collaborate separately? Or are you in the same room?
Well, for the tap dance kid, we were in the same room.
Yeah. The music.
I'm thinking of my late writing partner, Robert Lloyd.
I did not know he passed away. I'm so sorry, Henry.
It's almost a year now. Yeah.
Oh, it was a great, a great experience.
And incidentally, Ken, weren't you in Tap Dance Kid?
Yeah, I thought you'd never ask.
Well, if you'd been quiet a little for a bit, I would have asked sooner.
Hey, Henry, we were cast in the show, of course, and then we started in workshop form, didn't we?
That's right.
And how
you try things out and see how they feel.
Yeah, everyone out there I know is fascinated with you because of you're such a wonderful composer. And the process to get a Broadway show or any other show on Broadway, can you kind of tell us how what the process is to get it like the workshop on?
Well, you have to have producers that will pay for the attendant costs. There are a lot of costs involved. You have to pay for rehearsal space and pay for the actors to come in and do their work, and the writers get a little something. And you have to have belief. You have to have belief in it yourselves, and you have to have producers and director who believe in it. Every situation is different. I mean, today you have big companies like Disney bringing something in almost prepackaged and doing it with their massive powers of linking things, movies and musicals together. But the old-fashioned way is you come up with an idea, you write the story, and you write the songs, and then you try to get backing for them.
Yeah, it's those backers. Those backers, I'm telling you. And, you had such a great product, and it was so well-received. Did you say over the phone to me, am I crazy, and I could be crazy, that they were talking about reviving it soon?
Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
What? Do you need an old white girl that can tap dance? I need the work. That's a joke.
Well,
keep me in mind, Henry.
I don't know yet. But if we do, you'll be the first one to be called for that.
Oh, bless you, bless you.
Bless, as George has, Tennessee Ernie Ford said, bless your little pea-picking heart. But, I've been in touch with Hinton on Facebook, but I, haven't seen him in a long time. But he was such a wonderful lead in that show. Was that the first choice, can you say? Or, did he come in and just wow you guys?
Yes, he was the first choice, from the beginning. And now, in the new incarnation, he's directing. And co-choreographing with Savion Glover, who, as you know, was one of the children that played the Tap Dance Kid.
Oh, yeah. And Alfonso, he's gone on to do some, Alfonso Ribeiro, he's gone on to do some great things on TV, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's very successful.
Yeah.
I see him on Dancing with the Stars, and, he's very successful.
Listen, I'm fascinated also by Sideshow, so please don't go away, because we have a sensation number to play from your hit musical Sideshow. Hit it, Eric.
we're Siamese twins. I'm to your right as you watch our show. She thinks she's always right. Not so. I'm Daisy. I'm Violet. What else would you like to know?
What are your dreams? What are you longing for?
I want to be like everyone else, so no one will point and stare. To walk down the street, not attracting attention, no notice, no mention, no hint of despair. A normal reaction, the standard response, the same as everyone wants. I want to be like everyone else, but richer and more acclaimed. Worshipped and celebrated, pampered and loved, to see those who've laughed, feeling ashamed. A glorious, frantic, adoring response, the same as everyone wants. I'd go abroad, see all the sights, hear folks applaud, bow to the down, never to roam, find a nice husband and home. I want to be like everyone else, but not like my sister says. She wants stability. She would like fame. I'd like serenity. Frenzied acclaim. But we can't agree on a single response. What everyone wants, only what everyone wants, the same as everyone wants.
There are many people in the world, but none quite like Ken and Dorothy. And here they are, live from Palm Springs, California. Two for the show.
No, seriously. You know, Henry, I'm so fascinated with Sideshow and the Hilton sisters. I mean, how did that come about? You know, from way back in the old days, and they were joined together?
I was contacted by the original director, Bobby Longbottom, and the book and lyrics guy, Bill Russell. And they said, we have an unusual subject we'd like to make a musical out of, and you're the only person we want to compose it. Would you be interested in meeting with us? So I met with them, and I tried my hand at writing it to a song. It worked out well, and we just kept writing, and we kept working on all of it, and eventually we found Manny Eisenberg to produce. And we just kept at it for 5 years.
What a run, huh?
5 years, wow. People don't realize, do they, Henry, how long it takes and how much effort it takes to do something so wonderful, do they?
Well, probably not, because you'd have to be somebody on the inside to know all that. But it's true, it does.
I mean, you know, go ahead. No, I want to hear some more about that.
It can take a long time. On the other hand, I was introduced to a 22-year-old writer from Toronto, Canada, the beginning of the summer, and by the beginning of the fall, we had a new musical.
Wow. That is good. Go ahead.
An old-fashioned musical comedy. Took us basically 3 months to write.
Wow. You know, the music is so haunting from the show, and I listened to all of it before, you know, we did the program, and it propels the plot so well, which is, of course, isn't that, of course, what the optimum for the musical is, and you do that so well, propelling the plot.
Well, thank you very much, Ken.
Oh, and...
Yeah, you know, did you find it difficult to find a lot of information about the Hilton sisters?
Oh yeah, we dug pretty deep and had. Yeah, you hear my dogs?
Is that you? Listen, I think he's composing a tune right now.
Does he tap dance?
She just about does. She actually is Bobby Longbottom's dog. She spends the day here with us every day.
I love to know.
Well, you know, on a somewhat technical note, though, how the heck were the actresses joined together? I'm sure not with a safety pin. Kidding, kidding. But I'm really interested in knowing that costume-wise, you know?
There was no connection. They were choreographed to always stay close.
Oh, interesting.
There was no connection.
It was known as Together.
Wow, that's fascinating. That's really interesting.
And that must have been very difficult for them also, you know, to constantly think about not moving out and doing a solo as I would.
Well, you know, it's when you put your mind to something, and the two girls were pros, and they got to know each other very well. And as you, I imagine, would agree, a bond of sisterhood is a very strong bond.
Yes.
And they definitely had that then, and they still have it. They do concerts together still, Emily and Alice.
Oh, gosh, and, that's terrific. I love dogs. Listen, Henry, this is hilarious. Henry, don't go away, please. We have one more of your shows to discuss. But first, we have sponsors we need to discuss as well, so we have to pay the rent. Hey, roll them, Eric.
Okay, Dorothy. So I think we need to head to George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant.
What day of the week is it?
Why, it's Wednesday, of course.
Right, right. Just wanted to make sure. We can make that 2-for-1 happy hour from 4 to 7.
Oh, right. Monday through Friday. You know, that's really a great deal. 2-for-1 drinks from 4 to 7, and they have great appetizers to go along with those wonderful cocktails. Wait a minute. Are you wearing another hat?
I sure am. It's my cowboy hat.
Your cowboy hat? Oh, right, right. That's just a reminder that George's Alibi and Azul Patio is going to have one of those fabulous shows, a humdinger of a New Year's Eve celebration. This year, it's a country New Year's Eve.
Yep, featuring singing, dancing, a great dinner, a champagne toast, and a great way to usher in the new year.
Yee-haw! Well, we better mosey over to the phone and make our reservations. But for all of you, don't you mosey over to the phone because seating is limited. Now, don't forget, that's George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant. And remember, you never have to have an alibi to have a great time. Okay, we told you we would tell you how to order that great coffee from Coffee. Remember, that's Coffee with a K, K-O-F-F-I. Well, first of all, their website is www.koffi.com. Just click on that link and up comes that terrific coffee homepage. And if you put in this promo code, Ken...
Well, what happened to Dorothy?
Oh, never mind. Just put in promo code Ken. You'll get 10% off your order of coffee. And believe me, it'll be the best coffee you've ever tasted.
And they have several choices, so why not order all of them? And they make great gifts.
So, when you're in Palm Springs, head for coffee. That's Coffee with a K. And don't forget to go to their website, www.koffi.com. You will love it. Okay, Dorothy, so after those drinks at Trio's, where will we go for dinner?
Well, let's stay right here.
Oh, of course. There's everything to choose from.
Well, I love the scallops.
Well, I love the pot roast. And you know they have mac and cheese on the dinner menu, too? Well, whatever you choose, the food is truly sensational.
And a 3-course pre-fixed dinner is just $19.99.
Wow, that's a $40 value. Such a deal. Trio's. It's the place in Palm Springs for food, fun,
and a little vodka couldn't hurt.
So go to Trio's of Palm Springs,
where Palm Springs eats.
ladies and gentlemen, the Crystal Room is proud to present the club debut of America's newest recording stars, The Dreams.
Every man has his own special dream, and your dream's just about to come true. Life's not as bad as it may seem if you open your eyes to what's in front of you. We are dream girls, minds will make you happy. Yeah, we are dream girls, boys will always care. We are dream girls will never leave you. No, no, and all you've got to do is dream, baby, we'll be there, yeah. Dream girls will help you through the night. Dream girls will make you feel alright. Dream girls keep you dreaming your whole life through.
Terrific. Oh, we have seen that how many times?
Four or five times. It's just great.
I mean, it's great. But now, Kenneth, what say you?
Okay. Henry, first of all, were you on location for Dreamgirls when it was made?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, were you out here, you know, while it was being filmed? Were you, not location, were you, you know, with them every day?
Yes, the movie.
Yes.
Yes, I was not every day, no, but I worked on it. You know, I wrote several new songs for it, and I was there for months working on it. And when I did come and was on location, you know, I would say maybe for a week or two, not even like a week or something.
Yeah, I mean,
it was fun, you know, I got to rub shoulders with Jamie Foxx and this one and that one, and Eddie Murphy was really lovely, lovely guy to be around.
Well, I want to say they were lucky because they got to rub shoulders with you.
Absolutely.
Well, that's very kind of you. I don't know. I don't know what they thought, but I know.
I rub shoulders anytime.
Listen, Henry, your music is so great. Listen, your music is so great. They did it well, but don't forget, without the product, there was no show, and you were the product.
That's true.
Well,
yes.
I and Michael Bennett and Tom Lyon and the original people, the music is a big part of it, of course.
Of course.
I'm glad that I had the opportunity.
Yeah, you know, I have a brief excerpt from the review Frank Rich of the New York Times wrote. He said, when Broadway history is being made, you can feel it. What you feel is a seismic emotional jolt that sends the audience, as one, right out of its wits. While such moments are uncommonly rare these days, I'm here to report that one popped up at the Imperial last night. Broadway history was made at the end of the first act of Michael Bennett's, I will say Henry Krieger's too, beautiful and heartbreaking new musical, Dreamgirls. Boy, that must have been a thrill for you, was it?
Yes.
I mean, was the audience react?
You ought to think about that for a moment.
Did the audience just jump out of their seats for the show? They must have just been going quite crazy.
They were, and they are right now in London, England.
Oh, wow. Yes. In fact, I'm going to ask you about that in a second. But it was nominated for 7 Tony Awards, wasn't it?
Six.
Oh, I can't read.
You got that wrong.
It was nominated for quite a few, but it won 6.
Oh, that, gosh. And also, you won a Grammy as well for one of the songs you composed for the movie, right?
Yep, it's called Love You, I Do.
So
I won a Grammy for that, and I won a Grammy for the original show album.
Well, the original show album is just a great, great, great show. And you mentioned the revival in London. Tell us about that. How did it go? I know the reviews were great. Were you there the whole time putting it together as well?
A great deal of the time. I was there all through previews and opening. I was there for about almost 2 weeks during rehearsal. I wrote new material for it. I wrote new acts to open it, and my writing partner, Willie Riley, wrote a new lyric for the song Listen from the film, and it's just so perfected now. It's just so good. I'll tell you a true story. It was a Monday night, and at the end of Act 1, the audience was wild, as they always are. And the man had a heart attack.
Oh, and that's not good.
And they said, it was too much for him. And they said, just lie here on the floor. We have an ambulance coming. You'll be in the hospital in 15 minutes tops. So I got a little bit of a hospital. I want to see Act 2.
I knew you were going to say that. Oh, my. So did he stay for Act 2?
No, we made him go to the hospital.
He wanted his money back.
He'll come back. He hasn't been back already.
That is so funny. You know, listen, Casey Nicolau directed it. You know, I had known Casey just briefly. A friend of his and my ex-wife, and they went to some acting school. We had a party together. But he's such a great director. How did he? Can you tell me how it differs from the first incantation on Broadway?
There's a lot of differences. I mean, for instance, as I said, that there's a new Act 2 opener, and Listen reunites Effie and Gina characters. I wasn't there before. I mean, it certainly has a lot of the excitement. The scores, you know, the same score, but except for the additions. But it's, you know, Casey's just as honorary, and Casey's valuing people. So in those regards, it's different, of course, but it's still got the spirit and soul that it always has.
Yeah, and I bet, what's the name of the girl that does I'm Changing, which is, of course, such a dynamic number. The new girl.
Amber Riley.
Yeah, I read the review, but I didn't put it down, unfortunately. But I guess she just slayed the crowd, huh?
She's really good.
Yeah, I'm...
Blessed her.
Really? Gosh, I hope. Gosh, I wish I could get over there to see it. Well, maybe, maybe, maybe I'll win the lottery and we can dash over there. You know?
Oh, that'll be a dash.
Yeah, it will be a dash.
Well, Henry, what is the one show you want to do that you haven't done yet? Is there one there that you're thinking about?
I'm working on a Tammy Faye Baker show.
Oh, really?
Oh, tell us. I mean, tell us what you can about
gosh.
That.
Kristen Chenoweth is playing Tammy.
Oh.
Oh, God, that's great. So is it going to be the nitty and the gritty?
It'll be lots of things.
That's really exciting. When you do a new show like that, do you have to get permission from the estate or people like Jim Baker, you know?
That's not my department.
I said, that is, you know what, I'm going to remember that answer. That is a great answer, Henry. It's not my department.
Not my station.
Gosh, I hope nobody has a heart attack during that show. Now listen, they might though, if those eyelashes of hers fall off. Listen, have you started writing the music?
Yes.
Oh, that's great. Gosh.
Oh, wow.
Well, we're going to really... really look forward to that. You know, Henry, you've won so many awards. I want to ask you about, were you at the Academy Awards when you were nominated? I mean, were you at the ceremony?
Sure.
Oh, and were you, that must be so exciting. I mean, to be nominated for your work. Was it just thrilling? Did you go do the whole thing with the parties and the, you know, all that kind of stuff?
No, I didn't, because I had two tickets for the Vogue or whatever it was party, the big party.
Oh yeah,
and I had several friends with me, so we went to a restaurant with children, and we had a nice buffet dinner together instead. I'm really, it's not my thing, but all that stuff.
No, I
but
know
it was
you know.
Fun. We did. We performed three songs from the movie. At the awards, and we were nominated for three. It was a lot of fun to be there, and, you know, with my friends, and bumping into stars all over the place. It was fun, and it was fun getting home to my my life and my dogs.
You know, actually, every time Dorothy and I walk in the door, we go out to places or, you know, we'll do things nice and, you know, all that kind of stuff. We come home and say, be it ever so humble, it is nice to get home, isn't it, Henry?
You better believe it.
No place like home.
There's no place like home.
No, you have your things and you have your stuff. You know, I cannot believe that the interview is almost up and we have to say goodbye. Henry, I can't tell you how much I respect and value your talent and your kindness for being on our show. We just thank you so very, very much for coming on.
Oh, indeed. Thank you so much, Henry. It's been a pleasure. And listen, keep breaking a leg, as they say.
Okay, everybody, say goodbye to Henry. Bye.
Bye, Henry.
Bye, Henry.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Lots of applause.
Yay.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, God.
Okay, Eric, are you there?
I'm right here.
Oh, no, thanks. He's
you know, I was doing, I got a great idea from him. What I'm going to do, I'm writing the musical version of Lassie. All right? We're going to put Lassie on Broadway. We already got the dogs that auditioned, you know? So, no.
Well, you know, actually, Eric, is not such a bad idea.
You know, because, you know?
No, actually, that's a good
starring
idea.
Starring Lassie?
Well, yeah, maybe you, which, you know, we could get a costume. Which, you know, are you going to play the rear end or the front of Lassie?
Yeah, okay, and you're going to play Timmy.
He's bringing in an original.
Can't you hear Dorothy going, is Timmy in the well, boy? Is Timmy in the well?
Listen, I noticed you didn't get to play our promo for the show.
You know what? I got it queued up on the next set of commercials, absolutely.
Oh, okay, that's good. You know, seriously, though, Henry Krieger, what a history in the town.
Oh, my
huh?
God.
And, you know, he's such, I did, you know, when I was a tap dance kid, you know, I was in the show. And
you were a kid.
I was a kid. Well, I wasn't, actually, I wasn't a kid, you know, which is funny. But you don't interact with the, you do interact with the creative team, but don't forget, he was trying to get those tunes done and the arrangements. And so when you're, and I was just in the ensemble, you know, so I don't mean just, but there is hierarchy and lowerarchy and archiarchy in the show, you know, and you can't just go up to somebody. You could talk to them anytime you wanted, but you just can't, you know, bother them. They've got lots of stuff, you know, to do. And it was such a pleasure being in that show. You know, it really was.
Well, speaking of tap dancing.
Yes.
Yes. Again?
Are we going to do another number?
Well, you know we never get off. If it's a possibility, why not? Well, I see here it says not this week.
Right, that is correct. That's
but
correct.
You never know when the spirit might move us again. I think I need new rubber on my shoes.
Oh, God, again? That's another $25
drain. No. The shoemaker said 60 from now on.
Jeez, I get it. You know, I should be a shoemaker. Jesus.
Well, why don't you go for that in retirement?
As the Irish say, oh, Jesus.
Oh, you
Jesus.
Don't know what the Irish say. I know what the Irish say.
Eric, do you know what the Irish say?
Whatever Dorothy says is fine with me.
You know, Eric, that is the totally right answer.
I'm telling you.
In everything we ask you.
Now, listen to me, darling. You know how I feel about it.
Sure.
Anyhow.
Yeah, we love you more than our luggage. Go ahead, Dorothy.
I don't know where I'm at. Oh, yes.
Yes, you're
well,
right here. Okay.
At least we're honest with the audience.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
They know we're not always playing with a full deck.
No, actually, as Kathy Lennon, you know, after the show last week, Kathy Lennon was here.
We love her.
In Palm Desert, actually. So even though we did the interview over the radio, we went to have lunch with her. And because I choreographed the show in Branson, I knew them so well. She's sitting there. We're telling some things, which, of course, I won't tell on the air. Uh-huh. And she said, boy, you are so honest. And I said, you know, I am. I don't know. In fact, I just had a couple of incidences this week. I don't get not being honest. I get doing
You're
business.
Really honest?
Yes.
Okay, where were you last night?
I was sitting watching the Blue Tube. That's my honesty.
Oh, I thought I'd catch him.
Go ahead. Anyhow, tell your story, baby.
Well, now listen. You know, when I was in the Palm Springs Follies, we used to exchange stories all the time, you know, on our careers. And we went back to the amateur hours like Major Bowes and Horace Height, and some of you, I'm sure, remember those amateur hours. And one of the male dancers in the show said, you know, I was on Major Bowes. And I looked at him and I said, what do you mean you were on Major Bowes? And he said, I tap danced. I said, you tap danced? It was on radio. And he said, so I went to the audition. And then I was in the show, and I said, well, did you win? He said, no. Well, now you understand why we're tap dancing on this show.
Yeah, where we got the idea. Yes. Yeah, just like we did this morning, huh?
Yes,
yes, yes. Yes.
Well, listen, it's not a contest.
Yes, well, as I told someone recently, ready, Dorothy?
Oh, we don't go there.
We don't do contests. But we do commercials, so Eric, roll them.
Dorothy, I see you have another hat on.
Yes, I do. And I want you to think about this. You know, back in the golden age of entertainment, ladies wore hats.
Well, it looks like a Broadway marquee.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Well, nothing. Well, I guess that's to remind our listeners that we are not only pretty faces on the radio, but in person, we aren't so bad either. And we have a wonderfully entertaining live show called, no surprise, Two for the Show. Now take my partner here, Dorothy Dale Kloss, you know, the one with the hat, one of a kind at 93. The Guinness Book of Records 2009 is the oldest living working showgirl in the world and a tap dancer extraordinaire because she still dances like Eleanor Powell.
And my partner, Ken Prescott, star of 42nd Street on Broadway and winner of 2 Los Angeles Dramalogue Awards. And you have Two for the Show. And as Henny Youngman used to say, take my wife. Well, in this case, take my partner, please.
Well, that's not one of the jokes in the show. You know, it's a truly entertaining act featuring great dancing, great singing, great comedy, and tales told from the people who actually performed in the golden age of nightclubs, TV, and the Broadway stage.
And you know, the show has wonderful media throughout the show that tells you who we are. Oh, and we love to tell you who we are. You know, just ask. And, you know, not only that, but it features eye-popping costumes and a nostalgic journey through the golden age of entertainment.
Yeah, you know, too, for this show, we'll have audiences coming back for more. In fact, one fan just wrote, to paraphrase Mr. Cole Porter, "We're the top, we're the Coliseum." You were a nostalgic look to the big band era, Radio City, and the Broadway babies combined. Thank you for a fabulous show.
I knew you'd get that song in there someplace.
I did. I would.
Yes,
I had good.
So if you want a great evening of entertainment, just give us a call. Ken, what's that number?
That number is 760-409-1464. Or email me at hooferproduction@aol.com. That's HOOFERPRODUCTION at AOL.com. And don't forget, we are
two for the show.
Say, Dorothy, you know, I could really use a cup of coffee. Couldn't you?
I sure could. And I bet I know where you want to go, Ken.
Well, is there any other place? Certainly not in Palm Springs. It's coffee. That's coffee with a K. K-O-F-F-I. They really have the best coffee. And you know, the owner has great sticky buns. Well, what I mean is, they have great pastries, incredible muffins, cookies, and even great sandwiches. And the atmosphere is really relaxing. They also have a great patio to watch the world go by.
And you know, you can order their coffee online. So stay tuned and find out how to do that little thing.
Yeah, right after I get that cup of coffee. At Coffee, that's K-O-F-F-I, right here in Palm Springs. Okay, Dorothy, so I think we need to head to George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant.
Well, what day of the week is it?
Why, it's Wednesday, of course.
Right. Just wanted to make sure we can make that two-for-one happy hour, you know, from 4 to 7.
Oh, right. Monday through Friday. Boy, that's a really great deal. Two-for-one drinks from 4 to 7. And they have great appetizers to go along with those wonderful cocktails. Wait a minute. Are you wearing another hat?
I sure am. And it lights up, see?
Oh, you're all lit up like a Christmas tree.
Oh, well, that's over.
Well, yeah, it is. But what's not over are the wonderful shows at George's Alibi and Azul Patio. That's just a reminder that they are going to have some saucy, sassy, and sensational shows all through the year.
Yes, and you can make an evening of it with cocktails, a delicious dinner, and of course, that fantastic show.
Yes, and they have the friendliest waitstaff.
We better go. Go to the phone and make a reservation right now.
Yeah, and all of you, you go to the phone and make your reservations too for a great evening. Or you can do it online at www.alibiazul, that's A-L-I-B-I-A-Z-U-L.com.
And don't forget, that's George's Alibi and Azul Patio and Restaurant. And remember,
you never have to have an alibi to have a great time. Hey, Dorothy, I think it's cocktail time.
Oh, Ken, it's the middle of the afternoon.
Well, it's 5 o'clock somewhere in the world. And what better place to go than Trios of Palm Springs?
Oh, well, wait. I'll get my hat.
Get your hat? What is this? A Joan Crawford movie? Oh, for heaven's sakes. You know, I knew you'd be there. And they have happy hour all day long. And the drinks are just $3.
Well, we've been happy there many times.
We certainly have. And the drinks and the atmosphere are just great.
Also, their bar snacks, like the mac and cheese, are really wonderful. One of my favorites, you know.
Yeah, well, one of my favorites are the sliders. Well, and the spinach dip. Well, oh, they're all my favorites. And it's located in the Uptown Design District of Palm Springs.
So what are we waiting for? I've got my hat.
Oh, again with the hat. Put the hat on. Well, everybody, we hope to see you there soon.
I'm gonna love you like nobody's loved you, come rain or come shine. High as a mountain, deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when I met you, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true. You're gonna love me like nobody's loved me, come rain or come shine. Happy together, unhappy together, and won't it be fine? Oh, days may be cloudy or sunny, we are in nowhere out of the
Yes, that was me. And yes, we will be here each week, come rain or come shine.
Well, speaking of rain, it did come in Palm Springs, and I had a chance to wear my rain hat.
Yeah, well, you're the only person I know that has sequins on her hat.
Oh, rain or shine, I've got a hat for it.
Listen, speaking of rain, I love doing Singing in the Rain, and we just lost wonderful Debbie Reynolds.
Ah, yes. And I have a wonderful story about Debbie, you know. Debbie attended the Palm Springs Follies during the time Donald O'Connor was performing in the show. And one of the cast members had toured as a dancer in Debbie's act. After the show, Jerry Antes, hi Jerry out there, was taking Debbie to dinner. And as they crossed the street, you could hear Debbie say, "Well, Jerry, I could have flown to London back in the time it took for that show to finish."
Those were her exact words, but I won't say her exact words. So, Dorothy, why was that show so long?
Well, you see, the producer, who was also the MC, just loved the stage, and you couldn't get him off. Not mentioning any names here. No, I'm too old to be sued.
So, Debbie and Carrie.
Oh, my goodness.
You are now a sister act.
Rest in peace.
Absolutely. So, from all of us, myself, Ken Prescott,
Dorothy Dale Claus,
and Eric Martin Koppelman.
Oh, Eric Martin Koppelman. I love those three names. I'm going to have to get three names. I'm going to figure out something else. You know, actually, this Ken Prescott's not my real name, and don't ask what, because I'm not telling you. And so, until next week, keep moving along.
And singing a song.
And, you know, I looked at the script this week, Dodo Bird Me, and I said, and tune in for Richard Maltby. Well, Richard Maltby's not going to be here next week. He's going to be here the following week. But next week, we're having that wonderful singer and actor, Mr. Bill Jones from Glee. You know, I wonder if he has a spot in one of his shows for an old white tap dancer.
Just leave it alone. I'll take a job anywhere.
Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Oh, well,
yeah.
I guess it's, yeah. I'll ask him when he's on the air.
Is it time for us to go?
I hope so.
Oh, gosh, I'm so sorry. You know, Eric, it's been a show today, I'm telling you. But we have a little song, a little ditty to say before we go. We're pretty much on time today, too. I'm really surprised.
Oh, my
gosh.
Here we
go.
All right, ready?
Yep.
You gotta give them everything you got if you wanna stop the show. You gotta do your best no matter what. Never let your trouble show. You gotta lift the audience right up to the stars, and then you let them have it with the last 8 bars. You gotta give them everything you got if you wanna stop the show.
Well, we probably did stop the show.
Well, no, but we slowed it down a little bit anyway. So just remember, everyone, we are two for the show.
Hey, can I just say something after that song?
Absolutely.
After that song?
Yeah. Yeah.
We got your number. We'll call you.
A lot of people have our number.
I always wanted to say that. You guys did great. All right? Great show today, guys. Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Eric. So we are two for the show. See you later. Bye.
Bye, Henry. We love you.
In all kinds of weather, we're two for the show. We're two for the show. We sing together, win, place, or show. We'll sing some songs, in fact, quite a few. We'll do some dance steps. Show.